I'll see you at 1:30.
I will see you at 1:30.
Por favor, lávate los dientes antes de salir.
I plan on it.
Okay. ¿Qué pasa?
She's incredible.
I'm gonna propose to her today at that lunch, right after she wins that award for... She's winning an award.
I'll be your best man.
I did not ask you.
I understand. How do you know Bernice is the one?
Well, it's like Bukowski said, in that poem. If you're gonna try, go all the way. Otherwise, don't even start.
Does it work that way for everyone?
Go visit my friends Beth and Tommy. If there was ever a couple in love besides me and Bernice, this is that couple. I introduced them one hot summer night a few years back at an Applebee's on $2 Tuesdays.
They did $2 Long Islands until 9 p.m. You can get absolutely wrecked for, like, no money.
They spent one magical night together and just knew that they were gonna go all the way. Went to a courthouse the very next day.
And hey, good luck today. Give this to Beth. Hello, my name is Jonathan. Justin sent me.
Nope.
Hey, what the fuck does that guy want?
He doesn't want anything. I don't know what love is. And he says that you and Tommy do. So he invited me over here to...
No, no, wait, is he here? Is he coming here?
No.
Good, because he's a fucking dirtbag, man. I mean, a real low-down piece of shit.
He's my best friend.
I like your plants.
Yeah. They're, good for cleaning the air. Quite peaceful.
You want a beer?
I'm 14 months sober.
Oh, shit.
So, Justin's your best friend?
Since high school.
You should run.
I don't know about that.
I haven't seen Tommy in a year and a half, easily. Did Justin tell you how we even met? We were both barflies at this terrible Applebee's in Alpharetta, and I used to go in there every day after work, and then boom, there's Justin. We get to be friends. It's $2 Tuesdays. They used to make these Long Island iced teas that would get you absolutely hammered.
For, like, no money.
God. You sound just like him.
Thank you.
He says to me, I've got this guy. He's gonna meet me for a drink. You should meet him. So I'm like, sure. So in walks this guy. I've got a thing for older guys. And he's got these sad divorcee puppy dog eyes. And I melt. I mean, I'm fucked up. This dude is so charming.
What?
So then he goes over and he plays some redneck music and we start to slow dance. And he's telling me about all the things he's got going on, how much money he's gonna make. And I think to myself, all right, finally, a guy that's got all this shit together. I was lonely. I was looking for a way out. I wasn't in love with Tommy. I was lied to and manipulated by this pathological liar. So after his fucking gambling wiped me out, I got sober and kicked him out. This motherfucker even stole my silverware! It's okay. Every time I want to reach for a drink, I reach for that instead. It's a picture that Justin sent me of Tommy in Vegas. Apparently he had a good time.
Justin, I recently came into a lot of money.
That's great.
I got a guy. He's a money guy.
I really don't see myself giving this money back to him.
I love that guy. He's like a father to me. Justin's good people. He's like a son. We all gotta go through a little shit, Jonathan.
I keep it on me to remind myself that it's a slippery slope.
Okay. Okay. Thank you for meeting with me. Oh. He wanted me to give you this.
What's up, ma'am?
How'd the proposal go?
Pretty much it sucked because she said no. And so I went to Applebee's and then I met a really nice girl and she's right there.
Hi.
I don't even recognize you anymore.
That's crazy, because I'm still the same guy. This is me. Mm-hmm.
You don't recognize, you don't recognize me?
I'm still the same old guy. Same man. And you're a baby. You're a little baby. Same baby you always been. Right? Little baby. Little baby bird. Huh? Little baby bird. Little baby bird. Do you want mama to come and feed you? Huh? Oh, mama. Fuck you, dude. You're not better than me. Mister, nothing bad's ever happened to me. You're a fucking joke, man. I should have dropped your ass in high school, you bald bitch. All right, cool, man. Let's hang out. You want a beer or something? I looked up to you, man. I know. Oh, you're gonna walk out on me? Good. Fucking finally. First thing you ever did on your own.
You know, I looked up that poem, by the way.
Oh?
If you're gonna try, go all the way. Otherwise, don't even start. This could mean losing girlfriends, wives, relatives, jobs, or maybe even your mind. This could mean not eating for 3 or 4 days. This could mean freezing on a park bench. It could mean jail. It could mean derision, mockery, isolation. Isolation is the gift. All others are just a test of your endurance.
Okay, guys, actually, that is my cue to go. This is very weird. Do not look at me ever again. You actually keep looking worse by the second. It's a weird night. I really hate when it turns weird, when I'm just kind of just trying to have a good time. It got so weird. I don't even know what's going on. Are you guys dating or like just like a weird codependent thing? Thank you for the drugs. God, you need to call somebody. Call anybody. Call a hotline or something. That can't be good. What the? Bye guys. Never think about me and I'll never think about you.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna go too. I love you, brother. I think I'm just gonna leave this. I'm gonna leave this here.
¿Jonathan?
Ay, Dios, ¿eres tú? ¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo estás? Oh, sorry. I forgot you.
Hola, Bernice. Yo estoy bien. Muy bien. ¿Y tú? ¿Cómo te llamas?
Things have been going pretty well. Actually, my last campaign went viral. I got a promotion.
Oh, that's great. What was the
It was for Pampers. We had these baby firefighters wearing the
flame retardant diapers.
Yeah.
I love that commercial.
Thank you. That was all me.
That's great. I always wonder what happened to like the rest of the baby though.
What's up with you? You're learning Spanish.
Yeah, I'm doing the Duolingo thing. Got a lot of time on my hands lately because I'm unemployed and I'm on probation.
Really? Why? What happened?
I broke into a stranger's backyard and got caught skinny dipping in their pool.
Wow. That's... What's that? In your neck?
Oh, this?
Yeah.
It's a stencil. I'm testing out the design, see if I want to get the tattoo.
Well, what's the other option, right?
Oh, right, yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm guessing you probably heard about the proposal thing.
Yeah, yeah. You know, that was the last time I saw Justin, actually.
Really? You guys were so close, though.
Yeah, maybe a little too close. Have you seen Justin lately?
I didn't for the longest time, but lately he's been just kind of popping up, and he seems different.
Huh.
Get out of town. Get right out of town. Are you kidding me?
Wow, man, we were just talking about you.
No kidding. Do you mind if I...
Sure.
Ow. Jeez Louise, what is that?
Yeah, it's a like a design template. Probably gonna get it.
Oh, no, you should definitely get that, man. It's freaking sick.
Thanks.
I bet Mom hates it.
She does.
It's so good to see you guys.
So you got a bike?
Oh, I've always had her. She's been in storage for a while.
Really?
I think it just kind of fell out of the habit, you know? Fell into some other ones. I'm glad you're both here, actually. I've been meaning to call you both, but I just kind of keep chickening out. I have a lot of shame about my actions last year. I think I was dealing with a lot of stuff that I wasn't even aware of consciously. And unfortunately, the two people I love the most in this world had to deal with the consequences of that. And for that, I'll never be able to say I'm sorry enough.
Look, man, it's not a big deal.
Let me finish. You both held a lot of space for me. And for that, I'm eternally grateful.
Well, thank you for saying that.
Yeah. Besides, I think sobriety kind of looks good on me.
Oh, congratulations.
Yeah. You know, it's weird, but I kind of think I needed to hit rock bottom. You know, so I could put the pieces back together, find a higher purpose in Christ.
Oh, wow. Interesting.
Yeah. His love is no joke, man. Well, any hoozle, I just came in to top off the old agua. Okay, I'm gonna skedaddle. My small men's group is probably halfway up the, small group of men. It's a Bible studies biking group. They're probably already way down the street by now.
It's good to see you, man.
Fuck you. Small men's group. Fuck, idiot! Let's get the fucking script.
It was way longer than 10 minutes, man.
Oh, my.
No, you said 100.
I also said don't put on my fucking robe. Goodbye.
What's up, brother?